This is the well-known Nanchinman project among the residents. The Nanchinman project was first publicly unveiled in October 2019 during the Air Force Aviation Open Day, showcasing scale models of the Luanyao space carrier and the Xuanyu space unmanned combat aircraft. The core of the Nanchinman project is to build a global comprehensive strategic defense system composed of large strategic space carrier platforms, space unmanned combat aircraft, and tactical robots. The conceptual 100,000-ton space carrier Luanyao is 242 meters long, with a wingspan of 684 meters, and a maximum takeoff weight of 120,000 tons. It can carry 88 Xuanyu unmanned space combat aircraft. At the 2021 China Air Show, the production line model of the Xuanyu space combat aircraft was officially unveiled. The Xuanyu aircraft is conceptually designed as an unmanned air superiority fighter, featuring large meson ring flow generators on both sides of the fuselage and forward swept wings. Giving it a striking appearance, it boasts high maneuverability, stealth, and intelligence. As a space combat aircraft, it uses an inductive force field drive device for propulsion, enabling it to operate both within and outside the atmosphere, equipped with particle accelerator cannons and other weapons. At the 2022 China Air Show, the 1:1 scale model of the Bider fighter jet was publicly unveiled. The conceptual Bider fighter features a stealthy exterior combined with a complex variable geometry, making it look like a flying transformer. It employs advanced technologies such as full-spectrum stealth, manned and unmanned flight mode switching, drone command, and adaptive engines. The Bider fighter can quickly switch mission attributes by replacing onboard modules. It uses a variable structure that adjusts its aerodynamic layout in real time based on altitude, airspeed, and flight attitude. These two conceptual fighter jets differ from existing modern aircraft in terms of aerodynamic layout, propulsion engines, flight modes, and weaponry, truly embodying science fiction technologue. In reality, the more advanced the design of a fighter jet, the more it resembles something out of science fiction. The Attack 11 is China's first stealth-capable flying-wing unmanned combat aircraft. The Wuzhen 7 is the world's first high-altitude, long-endurance UAV with a diamond-shaped joined wing layout to be put into practical use. The Wuzhen 8, with its delta wing layout similar to a wave rider, is equipped with a rocket engine, boasting exceptional high-altitude and high-speed performance. It is even referred to by military enthusiasts as China's first space drone. Why do technologically advanced aircraft always have such unique appearances? The so-called unique appearance actually means breaking away from tradition or being vastly different from conventional designs. It reflects humanity's innovative outlook on equipment technology. However, realizing these visions involves significant technical challenges. For instance, in films, we often see aircraft with streamlined and compact shapes to meet the needs of high-speed flight, to adapt to different complex environments. These aircraft might employ transformation technology, meaning their shapes can change. In practical engineering, such designs are extremely difficult to achieve. Real-world weaponry also has unique appearances. For example, the stealth fighter bomber F-117, when first unveiled, had a complex polyhedral shape that enabled it to fly and evade radar detection. The F-22 and B-2 bombers have even more unexpected shapes. Driven by the pursuit of stealth and long-range capabilities, intelligent unmanned combat forces are not truly unmanned. Rather, the weapons are at the forefront while personnel operate them from behind the scenes. It is a high degree of integration between humans and weapons. The real winning factor behind unmanned systems is the human element. The drone units are essentially the pilots of these unmanned aircraft. In the Northwest Desert, a domestically developed reconnaissance and strike integrated UAV autonomously taxis on the runway, following commands. It accelerates and takes off, heading to the designated airspace for training. Runway 1, clear for takeoff. The command is given. The UAV takes off smoothly, even in ground winds of 363 meters per second, thousands of miles away. UAV pilots in ground cabins closely monitor the data from the aircraft, maintaining real-time control over the battlefield situation. When an immediate task arises, pilots use a combination of manual and intelligent operations to complete reconnaissance and strikes. This UAV is a large reconnaissance and strike integrated model, capable of performing both tasks. Its features or advantages include endurance. It can maintain air superiority for extended periods. providing real-time battlefield awareness and support to command structures at all levels. Versatility. It can adapt to diverse battlefields and targets. Strike capability. It can effectively detect and destroy targets. Acting like a ghost on the battlefield, we can have it loiter in a concealed position outside the battlefield for long periods, ready to join the fight at a moment's notice. Achieving a surprise effect. Compared to manned aircraft, UAVs have more complex control systems, and each system upgrade significantly enhances combat capabilities. Not only does it have a brain for flying, but the aircraft itself also has a brain. During regular upgrades, we frequently update this brain. In the continuous optimization of the UAV system, they will also conduct coordinated training between UAVs and manned aircraft, and even among UAVs themselves. To fully utilize the combat effectiveness of UAVs, we can coordinate operations with fighter jets, including early warning aircraft, helicopters, and even other types of UAVs, since the pilots are on the ground and not in the air. This allows for sustained operations and the ability to carry more weapons and payloads. Remote control facilitates centralized command and control, bringing a qualitative leap to our combat capabilities. After completing long endurance flight training, the UAV autonomously returns and lands smoothly. This is our control stick, which controls the pitch and roll of the aircraft. The throttle lever is on the left, and below are the rudder pedals, which control the yaw of the aircraft and its direction during ground taxiing. The pilots here are all experienced fighter pilots who have previously flown J-7, J-8, and J-16 aircraft. They have rich flying experience and tactical skills. However, transitioning from a cockpit in the sky to one on the ground is a significant change, meaning they have to start from scratch, from an empty slate to mastering the skies. They have to figure it out on their own when faced with a new piece of equipment they've never encountered before, with no references or guidelines. Even the basic process of taking off can be unclear. Maintenance personnel, who are most familiar with the aircraft's performance, find it challenging to handle UAVs. The advanced nature of these aircraft, with many components linked to electronic devices and complex software designs, makes understanding how to disassemble and reassemble the engines particularly difficult. Without study materials, without experience to draw from, and without anyone to teach them, they face the challenge of learning how to operate new equipment. They immediately thought of learning from the aircraft manufacturers and factory workers. Even though the factory workers were busy with testing, they would approach them with notebooks, jotting down everything they saw. Starting from scratch was the only option. The most obvious sign of their hard work was their dark circles, like little pandas. They were pioneers, eager to learn, studying day and night. Now, they fly over plateaus, cross seas, and navigate jungles, innovating tactics in complex environments and showcasing their prowess in information warfare and unmanned battlefields. We can foresee that in the future, whether in air combat, unmanned vehicles, or unmanned ships, these technologies will bring revolutionary changes to land and sea battlefields. The Chinese Air Force, the entire People's Liberation Army, and related industries have embraced the trend of unmanned systems. Various types of UAVs with different functions have emerged rapidly, marking a path that future weapon development must follow. The rise of unmanned forces blurs the boundaries of battlefield space and reshapes the modern battlefield. In this convergence of technology and combat power, China's UAV development aims for newer and higher goals. A new generation of unmanned combat pioneers is emerging, with intelligent unmanned equipment poised for future battlefields. According to a report from higher authorities, a black box with a water-triggered release device was found in an abandoned house southwest of Hill 58. During this bomb disposal training, reconnaissance units used UAVs to survey the area, based on the transmitted images. The bomb disposal team carried an X-ray machine to analyze the internal structure of the suspicious object. Once the nature of the object was confirmed, the bomb disposal team quickly deployed. The bomb disposal robot advanced towards the target area, precisely locking onto the target and using a water cannon to neutralize it. The high-pressure water cannon on the robot can destroy explosives on site without causing an explosion, ensuring the environment remains intact while damaging the explosive internally. Additionally, the bomb disposal robot can climb, grab, remove, and transfer objects, targeting different dangerous items for destruction. Late at night, the soldiers received another task. An unexploded artillery shell was found in a certain area. Through UAV reconnaissance, the bomb disposal robot quickly located the explosive. After scanning and identifying the explosive, it was remotely neutralized. Empowering technology is key to enhancing combat capabilities. Currently, we closely align with real combat tasks, target strong adversaries, and train soldiers in the precise operation of unmanned equipment. We are gradually integrating unmanned equipment into daily training activities, enhancing the coordination between manned and unmanned operations, and significantly improving the unit's ability to perform diverse military tasks. In recent years, the iteration speed of bionic robots has far exceeded people's expectations. Various bionic robots of different sizes and power systems have emerged, capable of performing tasks such as close reconnaissance and material transport in special terrains and complex environments. Some can even be equipped with weapons and ammunition for direct combat, making bionic robots the new favorites in the field of unmanned equipment. This mountain transport vehicle, named Zinlongma 2, is eye-catching in appearance. It has two pairs of swing arms at the front and rear, and eight drive wheels. The swing arms resemble horse legs, with the cylinders as thighs, the forearms as calves, and the wheels as hooves. The vehicle runs impressively, capable of four-wheel steering on the spot and switching to eight-wheel drive by lowering the front and rear wheels. It can adapt to different terrains by changing the type and number of load-bearing wheels. It can easily cross 1.8-meter trenches and climb 1.2-meter walls, whether in mountains, hills, ravines, deserts, wastelands, snow fields, or glacier. Zinlongma 2 can handle material transport tasks. The vehicle's weight has been significantly reduced, with the swing arms being nearly 50% lighter than before while maintaining the required strength. Its load capacity has increased by 50%. With a maximum speed of 40 km per hour on paved roads and an average speed of 25 km per hour in the wild, an army marches on its stomach. Especially in mountain warfare, where advanced power vehicles capable of delivering supplies in complex, roadless environments are essential. To improve reconnaissance and transport capabilities in complex and dangerous environments and reduce combat casualties, countries are increasing their research and development efforts in high-mobility unmanned equipment. Applause, applause, look to the left. This robot dog named Geta even attracted a pet dog to challenge it, despite its small size. Geta is quite strong, weighing 32 kilograms and capable of carrying 40 kilograms of materials, small but mighty. Geta also features voice interaction, head sensing, and facial recognition. We successfully completed tests on forest roads, gravel roads, narrow passages, single plank bridges, side clearance, and 100-meter sprints with multiple dogs. We are very satisfied with the results. In this grand event of unmanned equipment, there are many agile and intelligent bionic robots like Geta, this big guy. Called the Electric Yak, is the world's largest, heaviest, and most off-road capable electric-driven quadruped bionic robot, independently developed by China. It can carry 160 kilograms of materials and move swiftly, with a top running speed of 10 kilometers per hour, making it a modern version of the ancient wooden ox and flowing horse. Gravel roads, muddy paths, grasslands, sandy areas, and snowy terrains are all a piece of cake for the Yak. It also has terrain and environmental sensing capabilities, allowing it to handle steps, trenches, cliffs, and various other terrains, demonstrating strong adaptability. So, what is the key to the Yak's stable load-bearing walking? The Yak has 12 independently developed joint modules. Achieving a configuration with 12 degrees of freedom, it can perform movements such as moving forward, backward, left, right, and turning. It successfully unlocks various gates, including diagonal walking, running, and jumping, and can adapt to multiple terrains. This capability allows it to transport ammunition, food, and other supplies to soldiers in environments like plateaus, mountains, deserts, and forests, where vehicles cannot easily travel. The Yak also has a hidden skill, close reconnaissance, in complex environments that are challenging for soldiers. It continuously gathers battlefield intelligence and monitors target movements. This quadruped bionic robot named Police Dog comes from the same family as the Yak. Although it appears smaller, its autonomous reconnaissance capabilities are impressive. The police dog can autonomously plan its overall path, perform real-time terrain mapping, and avoid obstacles. Base. The robot dog has reached the reconnaissance position. Received. Begin reconnaissance mission. Search for targets. In the mountain reconnaissance phase. The police dog demonstrated its keen senses. It has the ability to navigate rugged terrain and hide in mountain reconnaissance positions. Using its head-mounted optical infrared 30x zoom autonomous gimbal, it transmits reconnaissance data of enemy vehicles and personnel back to the control terminal. Enemy vehicle detected, target locked. It can autonomously identify vehicles and personnel within a kilometer. In the future, it will be used in mountain reconnaissance, police bomb detection, security, logistics, industrial inspection, and levee patrols, among other applications. In early 2022, the world's first bionic whale shark, an underwater intelligent bionic robot independently developed by the Third Academy of China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation, made its debut. This whale shark, measuring 4.7 meters in length and weighing 350 kilograms, is almost identical to a real whale shark. It can highly simulate various underwater movements of a real whale shark, such as swimming in a straight line, turning, surfacing, diving, maintaining depth, and opening its mouth. It boasts advantages such as ease of operation, high reliability, modularity, energy efficiency, and environmental friendliness. It can be manually controlled or swim autonomously underwater. This breakthrough demonstrates the successful integration of China's intelligent underwater vehicles with bionic technology. In addition to the bionic whale shark, other models such as the bionic arowana, bionic orca, and bionic finless porpoise have also been developed, continuously advancing the deep integration of marine bionic technology and intelligent systems. Currently, China's unmanned boat technology has made significant strides. Some unmanned boats can autonomously perform tasks such as patrol, reconnaissance, detection, and search and rescue, entering a stage where research and practical application go hand in hand. This is footage of the first sea trial of China's first fully domestically produced 100-ton unmanned boat. This unmanned boat features a trimaran stealth design. Its successful trial marks a new breakthrough in China's autonomous navigation and intelligent cabin technology for unmanned boats. A fleet of 56 unmanned boats completed multiple tests, including formation maintenance, autonomous formation change, dynamic task allocation, coordinated obstacle avoidance, and fault-tolerant control, demonstrating the potential for autonomous navigation and formation control of unmanned boats. At the 13th China Air Show in 2021, Yunju Intelligence publicly released the core technological achievements of unmanned boat swarm control for the first time, the real-time demonstration of dynamic collaborative gaming technology for high-speed unmanned boats showcased the process of a high-speed unmanned boat swarm coordinating to encircle, intercept, and drive away unidentified maritime targets. A highlight of the unmanned boat swarm is its decentralized capability. The entire swarm does not require centralized command. Each boat acts as an individual with autonomous thinking, sharing situational awareness and making joint decisions, enhancing the ability to handle complex situations. Today, new combat forces represented by intelligent unmanned equipment are repeatedly making their mark in realistic training grounds, becoming the new engine driving the combat capabilities of the People's Liberation Army and the new lever tilting the balance of power.